acute hepatitis A. Infection is a viral illness that affects the liver, typically spread through contaminated food or water or close contact with an infected person. Although it can cause discomfort, pain and liver failure and death, if you follow the guideline explained in this video, you can get a complete cure from acute hepatitis A. The incubation period of hepatitis A is usually 14 to 28 days. Symptoms of hepatitis A range from mild to severe and can include fever, malaise, loss of appetite, diarrhea, nausea, abdominal discomfort, dark-colored urine and yellowing of the eyes and skin. Not everyone who is infected will have all the symptoms. Adults have signs and symptoms of illness more often than children. The severity of disease and fatal outcomes are higher in older age groups. Infected children under 6 years of age do not usually experience noticeable symptoms, and only 10% develop jaundice. Hepatitis A sometimes relapses, meaning the person who just recovered falls sick again with another acute episode. This is normally followed by recovery. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. If you have any of these symptoms, the first thing to do is to consult a healthcare professional. If you suspect you have hepatitis A, or have been in contact with someone who does, seek medical advice immediately. A healthcare professional can confirm the diagnosis through blood tests, laboratory tests to confirm hepatitis A, by doing a serology test detecting IgM antibodies specific to hepatitis A. A liver function test might be necessary to evaluate the amount of damage to the liver. Proper diagnosis and evaluation will help health service providers to personalize the treatment plans to be tailored to the individual needs. Number 2, get adequate rest and hydration. Get plenty of rest to allow your body to fight off the infection. Although fatigue is a common symptom, rest will aid in recovery. Additionally, ensure adequate hydration by drinking plenty of fluids, such as water or electrolyte replenishing drinks, to prevent dehydration caused by symptoms like vomiting or diarrhea. The third thing to do is to ensure proper nutrition. While you may not feel like eating due to nausea or lack of appetite, maintaining proper nutrition is crucial for your body's recovery. Stick to easily digestible foods like fruits, vegetables, lean proteins, and whole grains. Avoid alcohol consumption as it can further damage the liver. Number 4. Practice good hygiene. Hepatitis A spreads through contaminated food or water in close contact with an infected person. To prevent further transmission, wash your hands thoroughly with soap and water after using the bathroom and before eating. Avoid sharing personal items like utensils, towels, or toothbrushes. 5. It is important to avoid unnecessary medications that can adversely affect the liver, e.g., acetaminophen, paracetamol, and herbal remedies. 6. Get your close contacts vaccinated. Vaccination against hepatitis A and B is highly effective and recommended, especially for those at higher risk, such as healthcare workers and individuals with certain medical conditions. It's also recommended for individuals traveling to areas where hepatitis A is prevalent or for those at increased risk of exposure. 7. Isolation and precautions. During the acute phase of the infection, it's advisable to avoid close contact with others, especially in settings where the virus could spread easily, such as childcare facilities or healthcare settings, until your doctor confirms it's safe to resume regular activities. 8. Follow medical advice. Your healthcare provider might recommend specific medications or treatments to alleviate symptoms or manage complications if they arise. Follow their advice diligently and attend follow-up appointments to monitor your recovery progress. 9. Monitor for complications. While most people recover fully from hepatitis A without lasting liver damage, in some cases, complications can occur. Be vigilant for signs of severe symptoms like persistent vomiting, jaundice, or abdominal pain, and seek medical attention promptly if these arise. Remember, every individual's experience with hepatitis A can vary, so it's crucial to consult with a healthcare professional for personalized guidance and treatment tailored to your specific situation. Usually, hepatitis A is a self-limiting condition. Vaccination is also available for prevention. While there is no specific antiviral medication specifically for hepatitis A, in some cases, healthcare providers may prescribe antiviral drugs in severe or complicated cases to reduce the duration and severity of symptoms. With proper care, rest, and adherence to medical advice, most people recover fully from acute hepatitis A. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. If you find value in this video, kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified anytime we release a new video. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.